and welcome to my channel. My name is Carly, and this is Carly's Crafts and Interests. Today, we are going to be discussing Colin Dexter. Colin Dexter is one of my favorite mystery authors, and he is the creator of Inspector Morse. I got several books here. At least six of them. And a little bit about Colin Dexter. Colin Dexter was born in 1930 and he died in 2017. He was born in Stamford, England. His father was a taxi driver. He went to school in Cambridge. And then when he was in his 30s, he lived in Oxford. And Oxford is where a lot of his, you know, majority of the books that he writes about, all about, you know, the upper echelons of Oxford University and the indifference between him as a copper, meaning Inspector Morse as a copper, who did go to the university, but he didn't, you know, excel in his schooling at the university. Inspector Lewis is also based in, and I believe Endeavor as well. Endeavor is Morse's first name, and he doesn't like people knowing that because it's named after Captain Cook's ship, and he's kind of embarrassed about it, so he doesn't really. There's only a couple times where he ever lets it be known that's his name, at least in Inspector Morse, that's the case. I like his books because the characters are really thought out, and on top of every single chapter, he has a little quote that ties into each chapter. You grow to really love the characters. I particularly liked Robbie Lewis, his sergeant, because he's a family man. He was a copper who was trying to earn his, you know, way up through the ranks, and Morse is he's a bit hard to work with. He wasn't the easiest co-worker, boss, because he was Lewis's superior to work with. Inspector Morse was a longtime bachelor. He had girlfriends, but he never ever got married. He loved the opera, if you ever watched the shows, and also is mentioned in the books, you know, different operas and classical music that he loved, and he also loved crosswords. He also loved his pints, and that kind of gets him in trouble in a bit, you know. He kind of sauces his liver a bit and lands him in the hospital in one of the episodes, and he has to, you know, learn to recuperate. The last book is The Remorseful Day. Now, it's not a coincidence that Morse is in the title here. This is the last one that Inspector Morse is in because he ends up dying, actually. And that episode for me is still hard to watch, you know. And the interesting about that is that John Thaw was sick at the time, and he didn't have long to live, and he ended up passing away shortly after that episode had aired. So not only was it the end of Morse, but it was also the end of John Thaw, who played him so well. What I like about, you know, Colin Dexter, was also known to appear on the set periodically and do a cameo. He didn't want to be outrightly noticed. He kind of blended into the background, and sometimes you would find him. And if you wonder what the guy looks like, or looked like, here he is on the back of this one. This is Morse's Greatest Mystery here. And that is Sir Colin Dexter right here. Another thing about the show is that throughout the whole, each episode, including in the beginning, you know, part of the theme music is in Morse code, and it spells out Morse, you know, and throughout the video, you know, and the shows, Barrington Fulong, who wrote the music for that series, if you know Morse code, I don't, but if you did, you could pick up clues about maybe a victim, or maybe someone who, the bad guy, or something, you know, because it would be in the music itself, and it'd be different, you know, each episode. And so that's, you know, another thing that I like about it. I love the soundtrack. I love, you know, I've been to Oxford. It's a wonderful old college town, you know. I would never be smart enough to ever go to Oxford, but I've been to Oxford, and I have been in some of the buildings. I remember going there. I lived there with my family when I was about 15 to 18, and me and my brother, there's a picture of us, I'm not quite sure where that is, but of us on top of one of the buildings, you know, overlooking the city. And so it's a wonderful place. I've been to the Ashmolean Museum, where one of the mysteries takes place. The Wolf of Goat Tongue does, you know, that is based on this, like, this kind of buckle and thing, you know, it goes and part of it goes missing, and it's, you know, part of the mystery to solve that. And so I've been to that museum where that happens at, where it's taken from. And so for me, I can relate to that. There's also one thing about Inspector Morse is one of his red Jaguar that he has is one of his pride and joy, is one of his car. And very classic. If you know Morse, you know his Jag as well. And so that's just a wrap up of one of my favorite authors. I'll be doing this series not all in a row of different authors, but in interspersed of different videos I do. And if you like that, tune in. And if you haven't subscribed, please do. I'd love for you to be a subscriber. And I'm happy to show you crafts that I learn, and also authors that I love, like Colin Dexter here. And I would love to have you as a subscriber. And till next time, take care and have a great day.